Welcome, learners. Today we are going to talk about techniques for classroom teaching of listening and speaking, play and theater, part of course number 503 of D.El.Ed. We know that reading and writing and listening and speaking are essential skills of language. Most of the subjects at the primary level help in developing these essential four skills of language. Listening and speaking are essential for all forms of social interaction, and here today we focus on these two skills. In classroom, we often do a lot of activities to develop listening and speaking, from simple reading to poetry reciting, role playing, laughing, or sometimes even asking children to imitate crying can help them develop listening and speaking. All these activities help them come out of inhibitions, and then it helps them to speak and interact with others in the class and consequently outside of the class as well. We can use, of course, many pictures, many stories, including the TV stories, but we have to carefully use the audiovisual tools, as they may lead to passive watching only. Often the TV stories make children passively watch and listen to their stories. So we have to use these stories in such a way that they interact, that they talk to each other about it. Whether we interrupt their stories or not, we have to decide, but maybe after the stories or somehow we have to use the stories in such a way that children use them or children listen to them interactively. We can use several types of pictures. We can have discussions on pictures. We can have discussions on stories, surroundings, environment, climate, and other topics from their surroundings and daily life experiences. For example, I will show you some of the pictures which are in the classroom textbooks itself. Now, this is one of the textbooks. You can find such pictures. Look at this picture, for example. In this picture, you can see that a child is at home and is interacting with the father in certain situations. Once you see these pictures, you can ask the children to talk about such interactions in their family. We can have similar stories. For example, we can have a story or a poem on blindness. You can talk about Helen Keller, which are part of their higher level textbooks, their higher level series. So once we have any story or any experience being described in their textbook related to blindness or any such activities, then we can ask them to discuss about it. We can ask them to talk about it. Thus, this will sensitize also to their environment, to blindness and to other such issues. And at the same time, it will help them interact with others. It will help them come out of the inhibitions which they may have for speaking and listening. At the same time, when they are talking, the others will make sense also of what they are talking. So that will help them improvise their listening skills as well. While asking them to talk about all these things, they may be asked also to enact blindness, to enact their father using their dramatic techniques. In such situations, theatrical techniques can be very useful, because often children do not like to talk in the classrooms in front of the others. For this, they may be asked simply to enact. This will help them come out of the inhibitions. They can also be asked to read in class for representing various characters in a text. In a text, often there are various characters. In any story, there are various characters. The children can be given the roles of these characters, and they may be asked to read accordingly. Now, students playing various roles helps not only in enacting and modulating their voices, but also we can incorporate games in this manner in the classroom activities. Such games are very helpful in making them children interact with each other, thus helping them in their speaking and listening skills. The game roles help students pay attention to the meaning, and you know that listening essentially involves creating meaning out of the sound or sequence of sounds which they hear, which they receive through what we technically call the auditory channels, that is the ears. So listening is an activity in which we hear the sounds and then we make sense out of the sounds. So children may hear a lot of sounds, a lot of words, a lot of meanings may be created, but they have to consciously make efforts to create meaning out of the sound that they have heard. And while creating meaning, they improve speaking skills as well. Because when they create meaning out of the sounds they have heard, they internalize the sounds, which will gradually become active if they do certain exercises for making them active. And unless they have incorporated these sounds for creating meaning in their listening system, in their thought systems, they will not be able to speak about them. So first we have to make them listen, first we have to make them create meaning out of the sounds, out of the words that they have heard, and then we have to gradually help them in using these created meanings actively through imitation of those sounds, thus improving their speaking skills. It is important that children learn to create meaning out of the sounds that they hear. Now, various gaming activities within classroom or in the playgrounds of their school may help children create meaning. We have to organize these activities continuously for children. Activities related to songs, for example, activities related to various role play, they all contribute to the activity of creating meaning out of the articulations related to expression of emotions. Songs often express our emotions. When I just now had shown you the poem on blindness, it is related to the expression of emotions. And once they learn to express their emotions, it helps them modulate their voice. It improvises their speaking skills. So by expressing emotions in a musical manner, they get sensitized to speaking in a style also. Dialogues related to a story, poetry, drama, etc. help children assume roles and communicate in a natural environment. So we have to create such situations where they can sometimes write dialogues, or if not, they can be given dialogues to practice, and they can gradually improvise the voice modulations and the speech skills in natural environments using these dialogues. This enhances the language acquired through natural processes. For example, they can play Birthday of a Child, they can play frogs or other animals that they have heard, or there are many such roles. For example, you can ask them to identify sounds of the other animals or the birds, thus reworking the lessons on sounds of animals. Or, for example, they can be given such cartoons, which you may find in their books. For example, Bambi is taken from one of the textbooks, and you can find in many textbooks you have these situations. You have such cartoons, you have such peoples whom they can identify and talk about them, such cartoons which run into pages in their textbooks. You can see these cartoons. They all run into pages sometimes, and we can use these cartoons for asking them to talk about them. Such cartoons have visual aids, such cartoons have visual pictures, so they can try to imitate the emotions, they can try to imitate the gestures, they can try to imitate the expressions that they see, and while imitating these gestures, these emotions, these expressions, they may try to speak the words which are already written there, or they may even try to improvise upon the words. That how will they express it? How will they express that expression, that feeling which is being expressed in the cartoon? So we can have various types of other situations also. For example, we can ask them to become a tree and dialogue with the humans. For example, we can have such situations as you can see in their picture itself. In the textbook, you can find such pictures. Look at this picture, for example. Here is a human being interacting with the tree. If you are interacting with the tree, how will you talk? Now imagine a tree talking to you. Imagine a flower talking to you. Imagine such other natural objects around you talking to you. Imagine your bus talking to you. Imagine your school vehicle talking to you, etc., etc. So we can obviously give them such situations in which they would love to talk. They would love to devise how they are talking. You know that one of the important texts which is taught at the secondary levels, of course, is written about a Jewish girl. And that girl is actually talking continuously to her cat. So how will they talk, or how will they interact with their doll? How they are going to interact with their pet animals or the animals around them, which sometimes may frighten even them. So they have to play such roles, and we can have such rhymes also which help us in creating such environments where they can interact, they can enact, and they can talk about what they have learned in their rhymes. For example, let's take the rhyme, there is a cobbler down the street. It's a nursery rhyme or even later, sometimes till class 1 also it is being used, class 2 also it is being used. You know, you have heard this rhyme, there is a cobbler down the street. Now you can ask them to behave like a cobbler. What they see in a cobbler, how they visualize a cobbler, and they can talk about it. They can enact, they can talk about it. Mending shoes for little feet. So how do they mend shoes? They have to observe. They have to observe the sounds. They have to observe the activities which are there for mending shoes. Once they enact it, they can of course talk about it as well gradually. They can silently also just enact. Just by enacting these, they are involved in such physical activities which help them come out of their inhibitions, which often hinder the speech skills. So you have with a bang and a bang and a bang, bang, bang. So you see that just the repetition of the sound like bang, bang or bang, bang, bang many times can help them evolve their speech skills and help them evolve the meaning of the sounds of such activities like mending shoes or such other activities which they see around them. So mending shoes for the whole day long, you can ask them how to represent whole day long visually, how to enact the whole day long, what is their conception of day, what is their conception of the entire day. So mending shoes to make them strong, what is the notion of strong, how does the shoe become strong. So how to show shoe through their hands, through their feet, through their painting, through their such other activities which may be given in the class in form of painting, in form of such other curricular activities. You can ask them to make a shoe and talk about it and then imitate about the shoes through their hands to imitate and show how they would like to express the notion of strength, the notion of day, the notion of little feet, etc., etc. So representation of cobbler, representation of street, representation of shoes, representation of little feet or sound of bang or the notion of day or the notion of strength, they all will help them gradually speak if we ask them to enact these notions. In this process, children will paint, children will talk, children will discuss, children will explain their concepts, thus both listening and speaking will improve. This will be part of the dramatizing the poem learned. So any poem you can dramatize and make them learn further and make them talk about it. So it's not only the reciting of the poem. Of course, recital of the poem is very important exercise. But along with that, in order to explain them the poem, in order to make them understand the poem and also to help them externalize all they have understood in the poem, we can use the enacting, the theatrical, the dramatic activities. Take the story of class 6, for example, from the story Who Did Patrick's Homework from the Honeysuckle class 6 book of NCRT. Honeysuckle is the class 6 book of NCRT. One of the stories is Who Did Patrick's Homework? So we can ask children to play the character of the cat which is there. The cat frightens the small doll-like creature. Now the tiny little doll-like character who actually interacts with Patrick. And Patrick doesn't want to do homework, but he is being helped. So you can of course ask the children to interact. They can bring their doll, they can bring their toys, and they can interact with them, they can talk with them, they can of course externalize all their feelings related to homework, and they should be encouraged rather that they can talk all the fears that they have about their homework. So this will not only help them in their homework, but also it will help them externalize their feelings, thus improvising their listening and speaking skills. So children can play a bird. The first lesson of Vasant Bhag 1, class 6, the Hindi textbook of NCRT, it paints the entire scene as they visualize through reading the poem. There is a bird. Now, how the children visualize that bird and the entire poem, they can be asked to paint, first paint. The painting or such activities will help them internalize it, and then once they talk about what they have painted, what they have visualized, what they have thought about it, this will help them talk. So we can ask the children also to visualize how they eat. They can imitate their own eating without food being in front of them, and how others eat in their classroom or in the family, how their parents eat, how their teachers eat, how do they visualize others eating, how do other animals eat, etc., etc. And accordingly, they can present all these activities, all that they observe through the theatrical activities in the class. They can be asked to talk about their favorite comic characters. We can discuss the favorite comic characters and we can ask them to represent in class. For example, we can have many such characters from the family itself. Look at this picture. It's in the classroom, class situation itself. They have got this textbook, but how do they visualize each of these characters? And when visualizing each of these characters from the family itself, the topic is family fun. So in the family itself, there are various characters. In this picture, they can, of course, compare this picture with whatever happens in their family, how their birthdays are being celebrated and how each member of family is reacting. They can, of course, enact and how not only enact their expressions, but also they can imitate their speech patterns. So role plays should have in this process a gender sensitization also. And of course, when we are giving the role plays, we should be sensible and sensitive to other issues related to environment, related to gender, related to general social issues as well. We should know that the drama is not new for children. They have already played since their childhood, father-father, mother-father. They have, of course, arranged their doll's marriage. They have played school-school and so many such other situations they have been playing. So each child is capable of dramatic techniques, using dramatic techniques in the classroom. They are often inhibited. Then you may notice some difference in the talents, but this doesn't mean the children do not have the talent. Each child, the very fact that human child learns language by imitation is a proof that each child is capable of drama, is capable of enactment, is capable of using his or her speech and listening abilities for enactment, thus helping not only enactment but in the evolution of entire personality. Now, in this manner, during games play, children do drama like imitating someone, exaggerating something, and making excuses, etc., etc. Now, every child has dramatic skills, but children do not get opportunity. So, we have to provide them the opportunity in the classroom for such enactments, for improvising their language skills. The reason for this is that activities like drama, acting are performed only during annual functions or when some chief guest, etc., such other important people visit the school. Of course, even in such situations, often dialogues are written by teachers. So we should try that in such situations, we ask children to write the dialogues. We ask children to visualize something, to think of something. Of course, there is a risk factor, but we should try to minimize. We shall perhaps first ask the children to create such dialogues, to think of such situations, and then, of course, the teacher can guide. The teacher can guide also for the performance, but the children should be encouraged to actively get engaged in all such activities. Making use of acting as a day-to-day activity in a classroom is very different from what we notice in the annual functions, etc. So, we have to use acting as a day-to-day activity for enhancement of their language skills, listening and speaking skills. In order to use drama as a linguistic activity, two important points are to be kept in mind. One is freedom and the other enjoyment. The very fact that a child comes out of the desk situation, mostly the children are sitting all day along on the desk. The moment we ask them to come out of their desk, to stand from the desk and come out of that confinement and play a role and enact, of course they enjoy. This enjoyment should be used to enhance their language skills. So, freedom and enjoyment are the two important key components of drama activities which help in improvising overall linguistic skills. No special preparation is needed by the teacher or children for conducting drama in the classroom. It can be done extempore as well. Of course, sometimes we can ask children to already prepare for it. But not always, not necessarily always. The teacher only needs to encourage the children to share their experiences naturally. At the primary level, any incident, a story or cartoon that children see in their environment, any of that can be taken up for acting. For example, any animal, its movement, its complexion, etc., anything they see. For example, you can see in the classroom situation itself, you have "For my children, all my great excuses." So you have so many pictures here. You have so many pictures here. So all this can be used. The children can think about it. The children can think that how computer interacts with them. Whatever the children have seen or around them, and they can think about it, they can always imitate the animals which are in their surroundings. They can meow like a cat. They can imitate the sounds of frogs during the rainy season, etc. At upper primary level also, the teacher should motivate children so that they form a small groups where they themselves decide the topic, they themselves write the dialogues and act it out. At the same time, children should be encouraged to act out traditional games also and folk tales also, as this will not only enhance their creativity but also connect them to their cultural environments. Getting connected to their cultural environments is also essential, because this gives them the content about which they are going to talk about, and how do they feel about their cultural environments they can also talk about. As a consequence, it not only makes them think but also react, interact and go deeper into their cultural environments, thus giving them the content and the form to speak about, to listen about. If they have to speak about their cultural environments, of course they will pay attention to whatever is happening in their cultural environments. Thus, they will try to make sense out of whatever they have heard all around themselves. So, listening skills, observation skills and their representation skills through speech, they all improve. So, children may be given topics like, if I found a magic lamp, if I were the tiger, if I were a bird, or if I were a magician, if I were a clown, etc., etc. You can just think n number of topics. You can ask the children also that what they often fancy to be, what they often visualize themselves to be. Many children may say that they'd like to be the doggy because they don't have to come to school, they don't have to do the homework. At the same time, they enjoy their schools as well. So what do they enjoy their schools? That means they're interacting with their friends, and they often enjoy interacting with their friends. They often enjoy reciting their prayers, reciting whatever is being sung in the assembly, etc. So they can be asked to interact on these basis. They can be asked to enact their friends. They can be asked to enact their pets, etc. And whether preparations or without preparations, extempore, in fact, both should be practiced. Sometimes they should be given time to prepare and then come and present. And sometimes they should be asked to present, to represent, to enact extempore. It can be done at various forums, for example, during the assembly. You can make groups during the assembly and ask each group to enact, ask each group to present something. Let them decide what they have to present, just guide them a little bit. And occasionally in the replacement classes also, many times when the children go in the replacement classes, the other teacher is for some or the other reason absent and one teacher has to go and replace the class. So such activities can be used there because the teacher is not continuing with that particular subject. So replacement classes are excellent places where drama activities can be used, where theatrical techniques can be used to improvise their language skills. And at this level, improvising language skill is the most essential aspect of education. So we have learned today that enhancing listening and speaking skill is very important for children. Listening and speaking are related not only to reception or production of sounds, but also and mainly to creation of meanings in various life-like situations. Various activities should be undertaken for role-playing and dramatization in the class. Giving children this freedom, this notion of freedom and the feeling of enjoyment by such activities in the class help children improve their listening and speaking skills. Writing and reading skills should also be incorporated in these activities. The moment we ask children to write their dialogues, to think about their dialogues, and then come up with such situations, written situations, which they can read in the class and then consequently present, enact, represent using theatrical skills, they incorporate writing and reading skills along with the listening and speaking skills in the classroom. Thus, all these activities help children and provide children the opportunities in the classroom and outside the classroom for overall language improvement experiences. All children have the talent for role play. and dramatization. We need to nurture these talents for improvising their language and overall learning skills through language. Thank you.